Buenas tardes y buenas noches. Cualquier hora, yo no sé. Good morning, good afternoon, or good night. Whichever hour, I don't know. But I'm just here to talk to you about if you really, really, really want to learn Spanish, I just want to give you a few little tips. So, bienvenidos. Acante su manera de hablar español. Still gonna be welcoming you to learning to speak Spanish with music. Okay? Singing. Now, I have gotten some notes here, and this is what I suggested to my students when we were in school, and a lot of them did that, and those who did it are speaking Spanish. You know, a lot of times we say, I hear people saying, I took Spanish 2 years, I took Spanish 3 years or 4 years in high school and I can't speak. I don't remember anything. Well, not so if you do it this way, okay? Now, we don't all learn alike, but we can learn. You know, some of us are visual learners, some of us are solitary learners, or kinesthetic learners, all kinds of, and then some of us just learn with a variation, a variety of ways, but we can all learn. So let me kind of give you some ideas what you can do to really learn. First of all, read. You want to read as much Spanish as you can. And you have Spanish in everything. You buy a watch, or you buy a microwave, you buy anything, you just about going to have instructions in English and in Spanish, okay? So read. But read aloud, put a voice to it. You don't just want to read silently, because we get what we say, not what we think about, not necessarily. So you say it, speak it out, okay? And it'll become yours. You want to listen. Listen to as much Spanish as you possibly can. Like in the book that we talked about, this volume one that we're in right now, you want to listen to it, listen to the CD over and over and over. Not necessarily the soundtrack, because you're not going to hear any words. Listen to me singing and rapping it. I won't get hoarse and I won't get tired. I guarantee you. You can play me 24/7 and I won't even know you're doing it. So listen and listen and listen, and before you know it, it'll be in you. You say, well, I'm not even paying any attention to it. Doesn't make any difference. It's paying attention to you. That's why the commercials have music with them, okay? You, the little kids, they can be doing what they want to do, look toddlers. And when the commercials come on, they'll stop and go to the TV or radio and just listen and watch. And then they'll bob up and down with the music, because music, I understand, will put information in your brain, good or bad, whether you want it in there or not. It's just going to happen, okay? So that's why we like to play the music. So you want to read and you want to listen and listen. Volume one, you know, I'm finished with that. I'm done with that. Well, then go to volume two. They're elevated on up into higher learning, but yet and still, it's for all ages, okay? Children learn just as well as we have as adults. And also the volume three, go on, just go on and on and on. Listen, but even when you finish level one, you don't want to just discard it. Listen to it periodically so that the songs and things will get into your long-term memory. You want to make yourself some flashcards. I called my daughter-in-law so I could ask her if I could do this. She said, well, sure, Mom. So anyway, she did all of these things. My daughter-in-law never had Spanish in school or in college, but she and I speak Spanish together. We text each other in Spanish, and guess how she learned? With my series. And she's also published her first Spanish CD. Okay, and it's bilingual, and it's even on YouTube. Bridget McRae, sing the word, Acante la palabra, sing the word, volume one, and even her children are singing on one of the songs. with Spanish songs. So she has it. 8 tracks of Spanish with the lyrics. She has 8 tracks of English lyrics, and she has 8 tracks of just the soundtrack, so that you can sing it by yourself. Okay, and you can also get these on CD Baby, iTunes, and Amazon. Okay, and that's Cante la Palabra, or Sing the Word, with the pictures of the kids. Bridget, B-R-I-D-G-E-T McCray. But Bridget also got labels. She did just what her mother-in-law said. She labeled just about everything. I mean, every single thing. She had got labels, and she labeled. Even inside the drawer, you would open up a drawer, you would see a little cajita, you know, little drawer. And oh my goodness, she just had everything labeled. Clock, reloj, everything is labeled. So she made labels, and it was always before her. But that's what you want to do. You want to label everything, the television, the clock. You want to put labels everywhere, okay? And that way you'll be able to keep it before your eyes, and you'll be able to learn it better. Now, as you can see up here, we have probably a lesson 11. You may not be able to see that, but we recorded lesson 11 today. So we're just now posted lesson 7. But lesson 11 we recorded today, so we're doing this also, and it'll probably, I'm sure we will post this way before lesson 11. But the thing about it is that when you get to lesson 11, we've already passed verbs, how to conjugate them and everything. I'm recommending that you get this 501 Spanish verb book. Oh my goodness, Spanish verbs book, 501, by Barron. And you can get it at your bookstore, and you can order it on Amazon, I'm sure. And it is one of the best that you could possibly get to help you with the verbs. It has all 14 tenses. We're just starting with the present tense, okay? But by the time you get to volume 3 in my book, you had many tenses. So you want that, and you want a good dictionary. We mentioned that earlier. You got to have a good dictionary, a small one I recommend. And you can have a large one, and I have one even larger than that, and I've shown these before. But I had this one bottom upwards. So let me put it here. That's the HarperCollins Spanish College Dictionary. Very good, very good. Bilingual naturally. Spanish, English, and English, Spanish. The same way with this one. Okay, Spanish, English, English, Spanish. They are still available. Okay, and I have a Spanish bilingual Bible. As a matter of fact, this would be from the King James Version, but it's Spanish, English. Bought it years ago, and this is the one that I took to church all the time. Finally, I left the bilingual and just got the regular Spanish Bible, okay? So you might want to get that, and you'll be able to read the Spanish. So if you really, really want to learn to speak Spanish, you have to inundate yourself in the language. You have to build your own little Mexico. That's what I suggest. Build your own. Okay? Also, you want to befriend Hispanics, because very friendly people, as you definitely know. And I have a lot of Spanish-speaking friends, and we speak Spanish all of the time. And they are just be so anxious to help you. Let them know that you're trying to learn Spanish, and they would be just too happy. And as the more Spanish you learn, you start replacing your English with the Spanish language. So when you get up in the morning, and then your family will learn it too, instead of saying good morning, say buenos dias, okay? Just start replacing it, and the more you say it, the better off you're going to be. Okay, now, one of the things is that, what kind of time we have, sweetie?
10 minutes. Good,
okay.
Right,
10 minutes. Good, okay, well, we got one thing that I suggest that you do. Oh my goodness, you Google destinos on the internet, Google. It's a 52 episode telecourse. 52 episode telecourse. And it also has the English closed caption. And my daughter-in-law watched that with the closed caption. And finally, she started watching it without the closed caption. And she could understand it. And sometimes it's so frustrating. I'm not going to ever get this. That's because you're too anxious. Rome wasn't built in a day. That's what they told me. And I tell you what, and I just been trying to build it myself in a day. It's taken me years, and I love it, and you do too. So do whatever you have to do to get what you can. Now, talking about flashcards, I made these little flashcards just a few minutes ago, so for an example, an idea from this, what is it here? A 4x6. I cut it half into, well, cut it into fourths. And I made these. And what I did, I said, la casa, okay? La sala, remember? El radio, and I have el gato. So I have four words. You can make yourself flashcards. So on the front part, when I have la casa, on the back, I turned it over, and I wrote the house, and I drew a little picture of a little house. Now, you don't want too thin of a paper because you don't want to see what's coming through on the other side. We don't want any cheating. You really want to know this. Then, after you do it with the Spanish, you're going to say, okay, let's see. The living room. Can I pull that up? And see if you know la sala. So, do it both ways. Then you see the radio. El radio. See if you can pull it up. And just do a few at a time. Hey, don't wear yourself out. Okay, Spanish will be here when we are gone. All right, so you might want to make big flashcards, whatever. These are 4x6, and these right here are 3x5. You might just cut half, this half in two, make flashcards. But do whatever you have to do. And some of my students do that and put them on a little Rolodex. You know, one of my students memorized in 6 weeks, had memorized all 168 verbs in that verb wrap, okay? There are 168 verbs, and he memorized them all by listening as he's going to work, coming to school, because that was teaching at a junior college in the continuing education program, and he would have that Rolodex on the car to his pickup, and he'd just roll it over and just look at a word or something. And get it in his mind and listen to the CDs. And before you know it, he knew all of those things. So we have to do what we have to do to get what we have to get. Don't forget to just label your house. It doesn't have to be as conspicuous as all of my posters. But little labels here and there until you can learn it, okay? Well, thank you so much for listening. And I hope that this helps you. And until the very next time, hasta luego y que Dios les bendiga a ustedes ricamente. Adiós.